while continuing to defend the programs that were developed for the best off, the wealthy and well-connected over the last 25 years, and saying those are off the table. They must be on the table. We must fight for an America that works for working Americans. Thank you, Madam President.
The Senator from Maine.
Thank you, Madam President. Madam President, I ask unanimous consent that I be permitted to speak as if in morning business.
Without objection.
Thank you, Madam President. Madam President, last night the Senate unanimously approved Senate Resolution 185, a resolution which I introduced with my colleague from Maryland, Senator Cardin. Our resolution sends a clear message to the Palestinian Authority that any effort to seek unilateral recognition at the United Nations will have serious consequences for future American aid to the Palestinians. Madam President, the United States provides nearly $550 million each year in bilateral assistance to the Palestinians. This aid is not an entitlement, particularly at a time when we have an unsustainable debt of some $14 trillion. Rather, this aid is predicated on a good faith commitment from the Palestinians to the peace process. By unanimously passing our resolution last evening, the Senate has sent an unmistakable message that efforts by the Palestinians to seek independent statehood outside of direct negotiations with Israel do not reflect good faith actions toward peace. Negotiations have been a fundamental principle of the peace process. It was in September of 1993 when Yasser Arafat committed to Israeli Prime Minister Rabin that outstanding issues would be resolved through negotiations. This principle has also underpinned the Oslo Accords, the Roadmap for Peace, and other Middle East peace efforts. We want to see a true and lasting peace between two states, a democratic Jewish state of Israel and a viable democratic Palestinian state. Since 2002, it has been the policy of our country to support a two-state solution to the Palestinian-Israeli conflict. But, Madam President, the road to peace is through negotiations, not by subverting them and making a unilateral case before the United Nations. Unfortunately, the United Nations has a well-documented record of being hijacked to chastise Israel, one of America's closest allies. In total, the United States, under presidents of both political parties, has been forced to veto 11 different UN Security Council resolutions regarding the Palestinian-Israeli conflict. Madam President, I'm pleased to know that the current U.S. Ambassador to the UN, Susan Rice, has vetoed the latest UN resolution regarding settlements, which, like Palestinian statehood, is a key issue in the peace process. The resolution passed by the Senate urges the President to maintain this strong position and to announce his unwavering intent to veto any resolution that is not the result of direct negotiations between Israel and the Palestinians. I want to thank Senator Cardin for working with me in drafting this resolution. When Senator Cardin and I first discussed introducing this measure, the Palestinian Authority had not yet agreed to establish a unity government with Hamas, a truly disastrous decision. That action has made it all that much more critical that the Senate be firmly on record that aid to the Palestinians is now in jeopardy. If Hamas continues to reject negotiations or peace with Israel, we must suspend this assistance. During his address before a joint session of Congress in March, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu succinctly described the heart of the matter. He said, and I quote, "This conflict has never been about the establishment of a Palestinian state. It has always been about the existence of the Jewish state," end quote. Madam President, we must remember those words, and we must also never forget that Hamas is responsible for the death of more than 500 innocent civilians, including 24 American citizens. It has been designated by our government as a foreign terrorist organization and as a specially designated terrorist organization. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has made it clear that the United States will not fund a Palestinian government that includes Hamas unless and until Hamas renounces violence, recognizes Israel, and agrees to abide by the previous obligations of the Palestinian Authority. I urge the administration to suspend aid until such time as Hamas demonstrates a clear commitment to following these principles. Madam President, let me also thank the chairman and ranking member of the Foreign Relations Committee, Senator Kerry and Senator Lugar, for discharging this resolution so that it could be considered and passed by the full Senate before our 4th of July recess. The passage of this resolution could not have been more timely. According to press reports, the Palestinian delegation has made the rounds with nearly a dozen delegations in New York this week to build support for their bid to have a United Nations recognized state. Palestinian ambassadors from around the world are meeting in July to discuss their plans in Madrid. They have been instructed to cancel vacations because of the importance of this coming period. Madam President, I would submit that if the Palestinians were only willing to invest as much energy into the peace process with Israel as they have into this ill-advised rush to the United Nations, we could see the beginnings of a genuine and lasting peace in the region. I do not know if the Palestinians will have the support among the 192 members of the UN General Assembly. However, the Palestinians must understand that the cost of seeking such a vote will seriously jeopardize U.S. financial assistance, and that is evident from the 87 members of the Senate who co-sponsored the important resolution that was unanimously passed last evening. Thank you, Madam President. I would yield the floor.
Under the previous order, the Senate stands in recess until 5:30 p.m.
The Senate today approved a measure that eliminates the confirmation process for more than 150 lower-level executive nominations. That vote was 79 to 20, with 60